Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's tutorial, we're going to find the equations of both tangent lines to the graph of the ellipse that passes through the point 0,4, and the point 0,4 is not actually on the ellipse. So let's go ahead and just begin by making a quick sketch. We have the point 0,4, so we don't move left to right at all, but we do move up 4 units. When we look at the ellipse, we see that the major axis is the y-axis. So the ellipse is going to look like so. Also, if by looking at the denominators, we know that the square root of 9 is plus or minus 3. We're on the y squared term, so we have a plus 3 up here, a minus 3 down here for the intersection of the y-axis. For the intersections on the x-axis, we have a 4 on the x squared term. The square root of 4 is plus or minus 2, so we have an intersection here at minus 2. And an intersection here at positive 2 on the x-axis. All right, what we have to figure out, what they're asking is they want the line that's tangent to the ellipse but also goes through the point 0,4. So that means we're probably going to have a tangent or a point of tangency somewhere around here and a point of tangency somewhere around here. And if we go ahead and sketch in what that tangent line will look like, we're looking for something that goes through like so on the left-hand side and something similar on the right-hand side. So that's our basic sketch. Now let's start with solving this problem. First thing I want to do is rewrite this ellipse. So I have x squared over 4 plus y squared over 9 equals 1. I want to get rid of these denominators. So I'm going to multiply by the least common multiple, which in this case is 36. So 4 goes into 36 9 times, and 9 times x squared leaves me with 9x squared. Let's place that down here. And then I have 9 goes into 36 4 times, and 4 times y squared leaves me with 4y squared. And then I have 36 times 1 to give me 36. All right, I don't want to solve for y so that I can do a basic differentiation. So what I'm going to do here is use implicit differentiation. So I'm going to take the derivative of each one of these terms with respect to x. So here I use the power rule, bring this 2 down as a factor. So 9 times 2 gives me 18. With the x as the base, I keep that and I decrement the power down by 1. So it's implied that that's a 1 there. Plus, do the same thing here with the power rule, bring this 2 down as a factor. So 4 times 2 gives me 8. Decrement the power of the y variable, and since I'm taking the derivative of the y variable, I need to tack on a dy dx. And now I'm taking the derivative of 36, which is a constant, and that derivative there is 0. Now at this point I need to solve for dy dx, so I'm going to subtract 18x from both sides. So here I have 8y dy dx is equal to negative 18x. Again, to isolate dy dx, I need to divide by 8y on both sides. So the 8y here cancels. Then I have 8y here. And then I have two even numbers, so I can further simplify this problem. Half of negative 18 is negative 9x, and half of 8 is 4, and I tack on the y. So here I see that dy dx is equal to negative 9x over 4y. And what this is this here is the expression for the slope values for each one of the points of tangency as we go around the ellipse. But I'm focusing on this point of tangency and that point of tangency. All right, next, what I need to do is figure out what the slope of the line that's going through this point. They told us that this point here is 0,4. And we're going to label this point here as just x, y. Whenever I have two points, I can figure out what the slope is. And let's do that here. So the slope, also called m, also called the change in y divided by the change in x. And all that is the difference of the y values. So 4 minus y divided by the difference of the x values, which is 0 minus x. And this can be simplified to 4 minus y over negative x. And now that I have an equation that represents the slope going through the point of tangency here, I can set those two equal to each other, and that's going to help me figure out what the coordinates are for this point xy. So let's do that here in a different color. So let's do the -9x/4y, and I'm going to set that equal to 4 - y/(-x). Two fractions set equal to each other, so I can cross multiply to simplify. So -9x times a negative x gives me a positive 9x². And then when I multiply here, I'm going to distribute. 4y times 4 gives me a 16y. And 4y times negative y gives me a -4y². Now at this point, you got to be pretty observant because we need to do a substitution. What you're going to have to notice is that when we shuffle this around a little bit, I'm going to add 4y² to both sides. So we have 9x² + 4y² is equal to 16y. And what the tricky part you'd have to notice is that this expression here matches the expression we started with when we rewrote our equation in a different format. So here we see that this expression is the same thing as 36, so we're going to make that substitution. So down here, we're going to say 36 is equal to 16y. Now we've eliminated the x² and the y² terms, so we can just solve for y, and that's going to give us what the y value is for this point of tangency. We do that by dividing both sides of this equation by 16. So I have 36/16. I can divide both of these by 4. So 36/4 is 9, and 16/4 is 4. So here I see that the y value is 9/4. Now that I have the y value, I can substitute this 9/4 back into either this equation here or the equation down here. I'm going to just use this equation here, and that way I can figure out what the x value is going to be for this point of tangency. So I'm going to go up high to try to conserve some of the space. So I have a 9x² is equal to 16 times y. Well, y is 9/4, and I'm going to subtract off 4 times y, which again is 9/4, and that quantity is to be squared. Let's do some simplification first. I have a 16 in the numerator, 4 in the denominator, so those cancel. 16/4 leaves me 4, and 4/4 is 1. So now I have 9x² is equal to 36 minus, well, I have 4 times, well, 9² is 81, and then I have 4². I'm going to write that as 4² because I know I have a factor of 4 sitting here. I can do some simplification. There's two fours in my denominator, 1 4 in my numerator, so I can divide by fours. So that cancels. No fours in the numerator. I only have 1 4 in my denominator. So now I have 9x² is equal to 36 -81/4. Now to isolate the x², I divide each term by 9. All right, so 9/9 here, that cancels, leaving me with an x². 36/9 gives me a 4. And here I have a complex fraction. So that's really -81/4. And I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal. This is really 9/1. So I'm going to multiply by 1/9. Again, I see I can cross cancel. I can divide both of these by 9. 9 goes into 81 9 times. 9 goes into 9 1 time. And here I have x² is equal to 4 minus, well, 9 times 1 is 9. And 4 times 1 is 4. And let's get common denominator. So the 4 can be changed into 16/4 minus 9/4. 16/4 gives me 4, so I know that's equivalent. And I have my x². So now 16 minus 9 is 7. And I keep my denominator of 4. Then that's my x². Can't have x², I want x, so I have to take the square root of both sides. So here I see that x actually comes out to be a plus or minus square root of 7/4. So this point of tangency has the coordinates where the x value is, and matter of fact, let's write them both. Let's do the positive one first. So the positive, x and y are positive in this first quadrant. So the x value is the positive square root of 7/4, 9/4. And then for the, or in the second quadrant, the x value was negative, and that's the negative square root. Let's just write that bigger and neater. That's the negative, and it's square root of 7/4, and the y value again here is 9/4. All right, so what we have to do now is we need to figure out what the equation is for these lines. We have the points here, and we also we're going to figure out the slope as we write the problem. So we're going to use the point slope formula. So with point slope, that's where we're going to take the y minus y1 is equal to m times x minus x1, where x1 and y1 will be our points of tangency. So we're going to do the positive one, and then we'll do the negative one. So we're going to write our y sub 1 is 9/4, so I'm going to write my negative 9/4 equal to m. Well, we know m is going to be the, well, you know what, let's back up. I'm not going to use 9/4, and I'll tell you why I'm not going to use 9/4. I'm going to use the point 0/4, because that's going to make the writing of the equation easier. I could use either point and still get the right answer, but for it to be more easily written and less work, I'm going to use the first point here, 0/4, because I have a 0 as an x value. So I have y sub 1, which is going to be the 4. And then it's equal to slope. Well, I can figure out the slope now because I have the y value for this point. So the y value, or delta y, is going to be, well, it's delta y over delta x. The y value is going to be 4 minus 9/4. All I'm doing is a substitution, where I'm going to take this y value minus that y value, which we said was 9/4, and I'm going to divide that by the x value, the difference of the x value. So I have 0 minus this x value. Well, if it's minus that x value, I need to show the negative, and then root 7 over 4. So this here is the slope. So 4 minus 9/4 over negative root 7/4, and then that's going to be x minus 0. Well, if I'm subtracting off 0, I don't even need these parentheses, so I'm going to drop them. So here it's just going to be an x here. For the other equation, it's going to be the exact same thing, except for it's not going to be a negative here. So it's going to be y minus 4 is equal to 4 minus 9/4 all over root 7 divided by 4. So these here are the two equations that we're looking for, or that they were asking for in this problem. All right, so what we're going to do now is we're going to switch over to the graph, and we're going to actually graph this. All right, like we said earlier, this here is the point that's off by itself at 0/4. We knew we had an intersection here at 0/3, intersection here at 0/-3, intersection there at 2/0, and intersection there at -2/0. We found our points of tangency, so let's go ahead and put those in. We know that the first one we set was square root 7/4 for the x value, and we said that the y value was 9/4. All right, and then we're going to put in the, for quadrant 2, it's going to be negative square root 7/4. And the y value again is 9/4. All right, so those there are these here are the points of tangency. And now let's go ahead and type in our equations for the lines. So one of them was y minus 4 is equal to, then we had a fraction here where it was 4 minus 9/4. And then the denominator was square root of 7/4. And we knew we had an x sitting out here, so that's that one. And then the other one is y minus 4 equal to 4 minus, 4 minus 9/4. And the denominator here, we had negative square root 7/4, and that there has the value of x. So we see that this here even looks like what we were, what our sketch was at the very beginning. All right, so that sums up this video by ajspeller.com. And as always, thank you for watching.